Hi friends, today we are going to solve the first problem of the stack in data structure. Our problem statement given here is you have a empty sequence and you will given n queries. Each query is one of the three types. The first one means you have to push an element into the stack, two means you have to delete an element present at the top of the stack, and three means we have to print the maximum element in a stack. So this is the basic idea. So we'll write our function. Let's just delete everything not required. First, we'll take the input, total number of queries. And once we have done that, we'll write a for loop for I in range. Let's just even shorten the things. Let's not write a complicated code. And once we are looping through in our temp variable, we will store these values if it's one, and the value that is to be appended to this stack, and two means to delete these values. So we'll write a list function, list map int. The basic mapping function. Once we have done that, we'll check the function type. So if temp of 0 is equal to 1, we'll have to assign a stack, or here we'll be writing a stack in form of an array. So stat.append temp of 1. If temp 0 is equal to 2, we have to delete an element, so stack dot pop. And else we will have to print the largest element present in the stack. So max of stack. So this is the basic code. Okay, first let's run the code. As you could see, it passed all the test cases. Let's submit the code. As you are able to see, these cases are not able to pass, so this is still executing, but this will give mostly runtime error because of simple reason you have to optimize our code. So the question is how to optimize it. So for that, we could write another function called maxer equal to minus math dot infinity, and here we will check if length of stack is equal to 0, it's not equal to 0, we will initialize maxer with max of stack. And let's do one more thing just to optimize it. if k equal to equal to we're basically keeping a track of the maximum element in this stack. So in that way, we are able to optimize the code. So every time we do not have to again sort the list and find the maximum. We made a mistake, let's see. Okay. Let's run the code. I hope this will optimize the code to a great extent. As you could see, it passed all the test cases. So thanks for watching and send me your feedbacks. That would be really helpful, and keep contributing to this platform. That would help me to find even better solutions for this similar type of problem. And stay tuned.